Welcome to STEM Space at Home, a series of engineering design challenges that you can do from the comfort of your own home. My name is Aspen Meineke, and in today's video, we're going to be making mission patches based off of the ones that NASA astronauts make in real life. So what exactly is NASA? NASA, or the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, is what is part of the US government that is responsible for space exploration. These adventures in space are made possible by the over 18,000 people that work for NASA around the country. And for the past 50 years, NASA has led space exploration, whether that's putting the first human on the moon or sending rovers to Mars. NASA also supports astronauts on their missions, whether that's exploring deep space, performing spacewalks, or doing experiments in microgravity. Have you ever noticed the mission patches on an astronaut's spacesuit? Well, every time NASA sends astronauts on a mission into space, they work with a graphic designer to help design that mission patch. It represents important parts of the mission as well as representing each of the astronauts going on the mission.
For each mission, NASA carefully chose a crew of astronauts. The size of the crew was determined by the mission. One of the first jobs the new team was given was to create a patch representing the crew and the mission. The astronauts chose pictures, colors, and symbols that explain the importance of the mission. But the mission patch, which includes the astronauts' names, also represents each of the astronauts on the team. The astronauts could design the patch themselves, or work with a graphic designer or professional artist to create the patch. But like many other jobs the astronauts must do, designing their mission patch could be a challenge.
It starts off with this blank sheet of paper, and you can go start with any direction you want, but you've also got to remember that you've got crew members, you've got a flight control team, and you've got NASA management has opinions about the design, and they don't all match, and so you wind up getting a good lesson in diplomacy when you make a patch. Then once you kind of pick a general design, then you got to refine it. Where things go, the color placement, you finally get this proof that everybody looks at, and everybody nods, and you wipe the sweat from your brow, you breathe a sigh of relief, and then you go to print with the whole thing.
Right now, NASA is focused on the Artemis mission. What this is sending humans back to the moon and creating a lunar base there. The program is named Artemis after the Greek goddess of the moon, as well as a twin sister of Apollo, which is the last lunar mission's name. During Artemis, you will see the first woman and the next man walk on the moon, as well as take the next steps to going to Mars. This is the Artemis mission patch. Not only does the A stand for Artemis, it also represents the Greek goddess's arrow. And it also draws a line between Earth at the bottom of the patch and the moon at the top of the patch. And then the red line going through it shows a trajectory to Mars. For NASA's most recent missions, in May 2020, two astronauts were launched from American soil to the International Space Station from a SpaceX rocket. This is a huge deal because Americans have not launched to the ISS from American soil in over 9 years, and it is the very first mission using a SpaceX commercial rocket. For this mission, two mission patches were made, one made by the astronauts themselves and another one made by SpaceX. Here is the mission patch that astronaut Benkin and astronaut Hurley helped design. The shape of the mission patch represents the Dragon capsule that sat on top of the SpaceX rocket. The mission patch also has the International Space Station, which is where the crew were going to. There are also two small stars next to the astronaut's name on the sides that represent their family members. So mission patches are not just about the technical things going on during the mission, but represents the astronauts themselves. Activity, you'll be designing a mission patch that represents you. So for this activity, you're going to need some markers, crayons, colored pencils, some construction paper, and then any types of art supplies you might have. So remember, your mission patch is something that represents you. So decide on what kind of shape you want, whether it's a circle, a triangle, a diamond. It's all up to you to decide. Another thing we want you to include is your name as well as your spark. So, well, what is a spark? A spark is something that you're passionate about, something that you love to do, something you can't stop talking about. Whether that's video games, basketball, soccer, art, cooking, whatever you're passionate about, that hobby you like to do every single day whenever you're not in school, that's what your spark is. If you're stuck or need some ideas, here are some sparks from famous people. So my spark is reading. I love to read all sorts of books. So make sure your spark is something that you can draw or represent somehow visually on your mission patch. The second thing we want you to include on your mission patch is what do you want to be when you grow up? So do you know what you want to be? If not, that's okay. I didn't know I wanted to be a mechanical engineer until I was very late in high school and I was exposed to it through doing science fair. So if you're stuck and you're not sure what you want to do someday, think of your spark. Do you like maybe helping animals? Well, a career that helps animals is being a veterinarian or a biomedical engineer who helps create prosthetics for animals and humans. If you think you want a career where you learn new things and help people, you might be interested in a career in STEM. So for STEM, there's usually two main types of careers. You have scientists and engineers. Do you know the difference between the two? Scientists study how the world works. They might answer questions like, how cold is it on Mars? Or what are the rocks on Mars made of? And then an engineer designs new types of technologies to help people, whether that's designing a new spacesuit to go to Mars or creating a rover to explore a new planet. Many scientists and engineers actually work on things that are related to their spark, like the famous Neil deGrasse Tyson. His spark is astronomy, and he keeps working in astronomy to this day and even has his own TV show. If you like cooking, you might be interested in a career in chemistry or chemical engineering. These careers create some of your favorite foods like hot Cheetos, Takis, Doritos. If you like art or drawing, you might be interested in animation or 3D modeling that engineers do. Some scientists even have the spark of photography, and so they use an electron microscope to take photos of everyday items like guitar strings, cells, and even insects. Some engineers even have the spark of sports, so they love sports. And so they go into sports engineering and create football helmets to keep football players safer on the field. So again, to recap, for your mission patch, you will need to include your name, what your spark is, and what you want to do someday when you grow up. And for an added challenge, try and make your mission patch interactive, like creating a flap to uncover what your spark is, or having a spring and have something pop out of your page. If you need some ideas, here are some awesome examples. Best of luck making your mission patches, and I cannot wait to see them. Make sure to post them to social media using the hashtag STEMSpaceAtHome and tag us on Instagram and Facebook. I cannot wait to see all your designs and see you in the next video.